Generally speaking, I prefer not to use any sort of retouching in my videos. But there are times when the client demands it, or in some situations, I want to convey a feeling that will look better if I do some tweaking here and there in the footage. So why not? In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to retouch your footage in a way that will make it look closer to the concept in your mind. Retouching a video is a bit different from retouching a picture. In the video, the only thing we do is, for example, telling the software to set the hue at a certain range, and it will take care of the rest. First of all, my favorite plugin for retouching is Beauty Box by Digital Anarch. The plugin is both available for After Effects and Premiere Pro. I'm gonna leave a link to it below. Anyways, I personally prefer to send my work from Premiere to After Effects when I decide to retouch. Okay, I'm gonna drag and drop Beauty Box onto my footage. The plugin will immediately apply its default setting onto the footage. But if you want to take it to the next level, you should click on Analyze Frame. This will make the plugin detect and analyze the skin tone and then set dark and light colors based on it. In mask section, you click on show mask. Doing so will give you this black and white sort of mask that will show you which parts of the footage are being processed. Using this will make it much easier to rework some of the processing that has been done on the footage. By the way, I should mention that if for any reason plugin did not do a great job of setting light and dark colors, you can easily use this mask and then set the spots you want to tweak by yourself. White sections are the ones that are affected by the retouching process, and the black sections are the ones that are not touched. To do change, I'm gonna set the mode to add color. This will let me change the black sections into white ones based on my liking, like this. Okay, now I'm gonna switch off the mask. You can see the effect of Beauty Box in action. It really knows how to impress. Let's go back to the mask. Hue range, saturation range, and value range. The amount of the change and effectiveness you see in the footage is totally dependent on the footage you have. There are so many things that are in play here, guys. In this case, I'm gonna choose the numbers so that contrast between blacks and whites become more apparent. And by black and white areas, I mean the parts of the footage that are either retouched or not. You can see sharpen and color correction tools here, which will help you make your footage look more natural after retouch. To do that, you need to click on add mask and then play with sharpen and color correction tint to reach that balance you feel is right. Now I'm gonna move back to the first section of the plugin and set the amount of processing I want it to do on the footage. How much I want it to smoothen the face and stuff like that. Okay, it's done. As I said at the beginning of this video, you can also have this plugin on Premiere Pro. Yes, it is more resource hungry on Premiere Pro, but by choosing GPU processing, you leverage this power and experience a much smoother workflow. But in the end, it all depends on your software preference. Do and use what feels more natural and easy for you. I hope this video was helpful and makes your future retouching experience a much smoother one. Have a great time and bye.